My people also have the right to exercise their basic human rights and decide their own future. And that's exactly what they wanted to do.
And the security of the Armenian people in Nagorno-Karabakh is only possible if they have access to the rights and freedoms that are inalienable to every single human being. To life, to liberty, to freedom, and to the ability to determine their own destiny as a community. The right to pursue self-determination.
Since last September 27th, Azerbaijan has been operating an aggressive military offensive against the republics of Artsakh and Armenia. This aggression is in direct violation of the ceasefire agreements of 1994 and constitutes an extreme breach of human rights. In 1921, when Stalin was drawing the internal boundaries of the Soviet Union, the territory of Nagorno-Karabakh, Artsakh in Armenian, was annexed to the Soviet Socialist Republic of Azerbaijan, despite the fact that approximately 95% of its inhabitants were the native Armenian population. With the dislocation of the USSR, the Artsakh population held a referendum on independence. Their participation rate was 80%. The vote was 99% in favor of independence. The Artsakh people thus exercised their right to self-determination and proclaimed the creation of their republic, as has been done by several other republics after the fall of the Soviet Iron Curtain. Azerbaijan is being supported militarily and diplomatically by Turkey and has been accused of illegal practices such as hiring mercenaries, using cluster bombs and phosphorus weapons.
Good morning from the city of Stepanakert. Now we are in a shelter because Azerbaijan is bombing the city of Stepanakert. We have witnessed the use of cluster bombs that are forbidden by international law. Azerbaijan and Turkey are targeting civilian objectives like schools, hospital, markets, churches. And the purpose of these attacks is clear, is that they are trying to commit ethnic cleansing. Azerbaijan and Turkey are committing war crimes. Please, don't be blind.
Nagorno-Karabakh territory has always been a majority Armenian in terms of population. It was never part of a free and independent Azerbaijan. And by appealing to the territorial integrity principle for the geopolitical interests, the defense of Azerbaijan is only based on a decision to divide to conquer by a Soviet dictator.
Honorable senators, I give notice that at the next sitting of the Senate, I shall move that the Senate of Canada call upon the government of Canada to immediately condemn the joint Azerbaijani-Turkish aggression against the Republic of Artsakh, uphold the ban on military exports to Turkey, recognize the Republic of Artsakh's inalienable right to self-determination, and in light of further escalation and continued targeting of innocent Armenian civilians, recognize the independence of the Republic of Artsakh.
Je rappelle que l'Azerbaïdjan a attaqué le Haut-Karabakh et a attaqué également l'Arménie, qui est un État souverain. Donc on est bien dans une déclaration de guerre totalement asymétrique et qui n'a qu'une seule visée, exterminer, éradiquer la population arménienne, faire du nettoyage ethnique et un nettoyage culturel, parce qu'on sait que malheureusement, en plus de tuer des humains, l'Azerbaïdjan essaye d'effacer toutes les traces de la présence arménienne qui est pourtant ancestrale, qui date de plusieurs siècles sur ce territoire qui a toujours été arménien.
I believe by recognizing Artsakh as an independent state, you will eliminate this conflict for once and for all. Respect the democratic process. Respect the democratic referendum that was taken in Nagorno-Karabakh and the willingness of the people to basically have self-determination.
Το Αζερβαϊτζάν, παραβιάζοντας τη συμφωνία εγχειρίας και το διεθνές δίκαιο, ευνηδίως και ανετίως, επιτέθηκε εναντίον των Αρμενίων του Ναγκόρνο-Καραμπάχ υποβοηθούμενων από Σύρους τρομοκράτες και έχοντας τη σταθερή, φανερή στήριξη και υποστήριξη της Τουρκίας. Η ιστορία, αγαπητοί συνάδελφοι, είναι αμήλικτη και αδέκαστη απέναντί μας. Η ανθρωπότητα πριν έναν αιώνα αδιαφόρησε μπροστά στις εγκληματικές ενέργειες των Νεοτούρκων και οδήγησαν στην αρμενική γενοκτονία και την γενοκτονία των Ελλήνων του Πόντου. Η ιστορία μας κατεχώρησε στις μαύρες σελίδες της γενοκτονίας, αλλά ταυτόχρονα κατεχώρησε και αυτούς που εγκληματικά διαφόρησαν όταν αυτές συνετελούντο. αποτελεί ιστορικό χρέος της Ευρωπαϊκής Ένωσης, αλλά και υπέρτατον καθήκον να αναχαιτήσει τις εγκληματικές ενέργειες των Τούρκων και των Αζέρων εναντίον των αδερφών μας Αρμενίων.
I raise my voice, one voice, but my voice in deep solidarity to another world historical people, to a people who have been traumatized for over 2,000 years, but keep dishing out wounded healers, who have been hated chronically for over 2,000 years, but keep dishing out love warriors, who have been terrorized for over 2,000 years, but keep dishing out unbelievable freedom fighters. I'm talking about an Armenian people who go all the way back.
Azerbaijan, the military is moving in on many fronts. They're bombing all of Karabakh. What happens in the worst case scenario for you if they take control of this territory?
I don't really like answering hypothetical questions, but I don't even consider that question. Because if I don't think of it as something possible, I will never give in. And that's the mindset of every single Karabakhi who lives here. That's why we're still here, even though they're attacking, even though they want to kill us, but we're gonna stay here.